हेलो एवरीवन, इस पूरी सीरीज के अंदर हम पूरे सिलेबस को कवर करेंगे ऑन डिजिटल लॉजिक। और डिजिटल लॉजिक के अंदर जितने भी सिलेबस है, पूरा जो स्टार्टिंग से एंड तक हम पूरा टॉपिक जो है सब कवर करेंगे, और उसके साथ साथ हम कुछ प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस को भी यहाँ पर कवर करेंगे। तो आई होप जो क्लासेस है आपके लिए काफ़ी बेनिफिशियल रहेगा। तो आई थिंक यू नो माई नेम, माई नेम इज़ हिमांशु कौशिक, और मुझे गेट की फील्ड में स्टूडेंट्स को पढ़ाते हुए बहुत टाइम हो चुका है। मैं इंडिया के बेस्ट इंस्टीट्यूशंस के साथ ऑलरेडी काम कर चुका हूँ, और सब पहली बार मैंने गेट एग्ज़ाम क्लियर किया था, दैट वॉज इन 2011-12। तो ऑब्वियसली आप देख सकते हो कि इसी फील्ड में मुझे लगभग 10 साल से ज़्यादा एक्सपीरियंस हो चुका है। तो ऑब्वियसली हमारा जो एक्सपीरियंस है आपके लिए काफ़ी बेनिफिशियल रहेगा, तो इसी वजह से आप जो हमारी क्लासेस है उसको ज्वाइन कर सकते हैं। और अगर आप मेरा कोई भी कोर्स लेना चाहते हैं ऑन अन अकेडमी, तो अन अकेडमी पे मेरे पास दो तरह के कोर्सेज जो होते हैं। पहला जो है दैट इज़ कॉल्ड प्लस कोर्स, एंड सेकेंड इज़ आइकॉनिक कोर्स। तो प्लस कोर्स में स्पेशल ये है कि यहाँ पर इंडिया के बेस्ट टीचर्स यहाँ पर होते हैं, और साथ साथ में जो मेरी क्लासेस होती है काफ़ी इंट्रैक्टिव होती है, यानी कि आप और मैं क्लासेस के बीच में इंट्रैक्टिव या डिस्कशन हम लोग कर सकते हैं। और साथ साथ में जब आप आइकॉनिक कोर्स में जाएंगे तो आइकॉनिक में स्पेशल है, स्पेशल ये है कि एक मेंटर आपके साथ हमेशा साथ रहेगा। तो मेंटर, जब भी आपको कोई भी डाउट रहेगा, आपको कोई भी नोट्स की ज़रूरत होगी या फिर आपको कोई मोटिवेशन की ज़रूरत होगी, तो मेंटर हमेशा आपको सपोर्ट करेगा इन एनी वे। तो अगर मेरा कोई भी कोर्स लेना चाहते हैं विद अन अकेडमी, चाहे आप प्लस ले या फिर आइकॉनिक ले, मेरा कोई भी कोर्स अगर आप लेना चाहते हैं, जस्ट यूज़ अ कूपन कोड विच इज़ कौशिक 10, क्योंकि कौशिक 10 में आपको टोटल 10% ऑफ हमको मिल जाएगा। जस्ट यूज दिस एंड होप यू लाइक दिस। पूरी सीरीज जो है आपको बहुत अच्छी लगेगी, एंड थैंक यू सो मच।
हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू आवर फर्स्ट सब्जेक्ट डिजिटल लॉजिक। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग डिजिटल लॉजिक, लेट अस लुक एट द सिलेबस दैट वी आर गोइंग टू हैव। सो इन डिजिटल लॉजिक वी हैव द फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स इन गेट। नंबर वन, बुलियन अलजेब्रा। नंबर टू, मिनिमाइजेशन। नंबर थ्री, कॉम्बिनेशनल सर्किट। नंबर फोर, सिक्वेंशियल सर्किट। एंड नंबर फाइव इज नंबर सिस्टम। सो वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग विद बुलियन अलजेब्रा इन द बिगिनिंग। सो दिस बुलियन अलजेब्रा विल टेक अस अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 2 and 2.5 hours, एंड देन दिस मिनिमाइजेशन विल टेक अस अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 5 to 6 hours। सो दिस इज अ वेरी लेंथी टॉपिक, बिकॉज हियर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द सर्किट मिनिमाइजेशन, विच इंक्लूड्स के मैप and other methodologies to minimize and boolean expression. And then combinational circuit will take us approximately 10 to 12 hours to complete. Sequential circuit will again take us 10 to 12 hours to complete. And this number system topic will take us 5 to 6 hours to complete. So in total, this entire subject will take us 40 to 54 hours roughly. More than 40 hours, because if we include the previous year question solutions also, it should take us between somewhere around 50 to 60 hours to complete this entire subject. And this subject you have also have studied in your BTech, in the first semester of your BTech. And if you are from other backgrounds, maybe you have done MCA or you have done BCA or BSc IT, MSc IT. In all of those subjects, in all of those courses, this subject is basically in your first semester of BTech, in your first semester of those courses. So I'm assuming that you already have some knowledge regarding Boolean algebra or digital logic that you have studied in your initial semesters of your graduation. So again, I will take this subject from the very basics. Even if you are out of touch from the subject, still I'm going to take this subject from very very basics. अगर आपको सब कुछ आप भूल चुके हैं, और इफ़ यू आर स्टडिंग इट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, स्टिल यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड डिजिटल लॉजिक। दिस इज व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू डू हियर। ओके, सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद बुलियन अलजेब्रा। इन बुलियन अलजेब्रा, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई डिजिटल लॉजिक, व्हाई वी हैव डिजिटल सर्किट्स। डिजिटल सर्किट्स क्यों हैं हमारे पास? सो इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट वेन एवर वी ट्रांसफर सिग्नल from one location to another location, it can be anything. The signal, you can transfer the signal in a computer network through fiber optics cable, or maybe you want to transfer the signal within a same computer system from one device to another. Just say, for example, you're transferring from hard disk to the main memory or to the secondary memory, something like this. So in all those cases, we use signals in your systems as digital signals. We do not use the analog signal. What is the difference between both analog and digital signals? Let me show you with the help of an example. So if you know that your analog signal looks something like this, your analog signal looks something like this, right? So in this analog signal, the values of this signal matters. They say maybe here I'm representing plus 5 volt, here I'm representing maybe 0.35 volts, here I'm representing something like 0.25 volts or something, right? So whatever the value of these signals, these values matters. Now what if there is some disturbance in the network? What if there's some disturbance in the signal? Now if there's some disturbance in the signal, what will happen? This signal will lose its, you know, values, right? So because the values will get affected, so getting the data back, jo data aapka signal se lost hua hai, getting the data back is very difficult in that case. But rather, if you use a digital signal, because in digital signal we have only two values, that is zeros and ones, right? So most of the time we represent a value 1 by using plus 5 volt and we represent a value 0 by using plus 3 volt, okay? So your digital signals look something like this, that we have a 1, then we have a 0, then we have a 1, then we have a 0, then we have zeros, ones, and so on like this. So it is not having any other in between values. It is not having a value like 3.5, 2.7. These kind of values in digital signals, we do not get these kind of values. And because of that, even if the data gets corrupted, even if the signal gets corrupted, it is very easy to recover the data from the signal. Let me show you with the help of an example here. So as you can see here, this is the original data message, original message that we want to send. It is 01010010. So this peak is representing a signal as 1 and this is representing a signal as 0. So if you want to send this data and somehow while sending this data, your signal gets corrupted. So if your signals get corrupted, something like this, some distortions will come up, some distortions will come up, and because of that distortions, your signal will get corrupted. Now, but you can see clearly here that even if we have such kind of distortions, getting back the original signal is much easier. So because getting back the original signal is much easier, so we will not be losing any kind of data. Aapka koi bhi data loss yahan par nahi hoga. You will not be losing any kind of data here, okay? So that is why using a digital signal is much beneficial as compared to using the analog signal for data communication, right? So in your Boolean algebra, when you studied this Boolean algebra in your college, so this subject is also called as digital logic. This subject, sometimes in some universities, they call it as digital electronics. In some universities, they call it as digital circuit design. In some universities, they call it as digital logic design. So there are many, many names for the same subject. And you have studied some of the basic gates. You have studied some of the basic operations, like you have an AND operation, OR operation, NOT operation, XOR operation, and XNOR operation. AND operation is generally denoted by a dot operator. So if I say we have A dot B, which can also be written as AB, right? So sometimes we miss this dot because it is very obvious that between A and B we have a dot. So this is representing your AND operation. This OR operation is represented by your plus operator. So if you write A plus B, so that means A OR B. Then you have NOT operation. So this NOT operation is represented by a complementation operator, right? So it is represented by A complement something like this. So it reverses the value. So if the value is 1, it reverses the value to 0. If the value is 0, it reverses the value as 1. Then this XOR operation is represented by this sign. And this XNOR operation is represented by this sign. You have seen most of these operations in your BTEC. Now, it also happens that for different kind of Boolean algebra, we use different symbols, right? So for example, for AND operation, we use dot. We can also use this sign. So this sign is representing conjunction. For OR operation, we can use a plus sign or we can use this sign, which is representing a disjunction. For NOT operation, in some books, they're using this sign. In some books, they're using this sign for complementation. In some books, they're using this single, you know, comma on the top to represent the complementation or the NOT operation. Then we have XOR operations. Right now, just for simplicity purpose, we are going to follow the same notation. For XOR operations, we have different notations in different cases, it's different scenarios and different books. Because it is not necessary that you have only this kind of Boolean algebra. You can have different structures of Boolean algebra. There are many structures of Boolean algebra. Let me explain you with the help of an example here. So first of all, let us see what does these operators mean. In sabhi operators ka matlab kya hai? When we do this AND operator, so this AND operator is represented by this symbol graphically. And the truth values are as follows. So if the value of x is 0, y is 0, then the value of x dot y, or you can say x and y, is 0. So these values only 1 if both of them are 1. Jab dono inputs ki value 1 hogi, agar input x ki bhi value 1 hai aur input y ki bhi value 1 hai, tabhi yahan par jo resultant function hai, jo resultant hai, uska output bhi 1 hoga AND ke case mein. Lekin jab hum OR ki baat karte hain, in case of OR, so whenever any one of them is true, yani ki dono mein se agar kisi ek ki bhi value 1 hai, even if x is having a value 1 or y is having a value 1, agar dono mein se kisi ek ki value bhi 1 hai, in that case the function returns a value true, or you can say 1. And then we have inverter operator. So inverter operator, again, it is a complementation operation. You can also represent it by x complement like this. So in this inverter operator, if you give an input as 0, it will change the input as 1. If you give input as 1, it will change the input as 0. So in the same way, when you look at the other operators here, like here we have the buffer gate. So this buffer gate means whatever input you will give, it will give the same input as the output, but with some delay. Buffer gate means whatever input you will be giving, it will give exactly the same output. Then you have the NAND operator. Now in this NAND operator, it is basically NAND is x dot y whole complementation. It is the opposite of AND. So I've just used an AND gate here, and with this AND gate I'm using a NOT operator. Hum AND gate ke saath ek NOT operator ko use karenge, to hamara banega NAND gate. So all the values here, these are opposite of AND. So what I can simply do is I can take x dot y and I can do a complement of x dot y. So that is what the value of this function says. So AND operator was having a value 1 here and all other values were 0, but in this NAND operator only this value will be 0 and all the other values will be 1. Then you have this NOR operator. So in this NOR operator is simply basically x plus y, that is OR operator, and you are going to add a complement on the OR operator. So ye aap kar aap check karenge, this is representing your OR gate and this is representing your NOT operation. So OR plus NOT is your NOR operation. So it is having a value 1 when both of them are 0, otherwise it is having a value 0 in all other conditions. Iski sirf isi ek case mein value 1 hai, baaki sabhi cases mein iski value 0 hai. Clear? So I think you have already seen this in your BTech. In the same way, here we have exclusive OR and exclusive NOR operator. Exclusive OR is also called as XOR, and exclusive NOR operation is also called as XNOR. We also call it as XNOR operator. Okay. So exclusive OR is basically X Y complement plus X complement Y, and exclusive NOR operator is X complement Y complement plus X Y. So they have a little difference here. So if I just add a NOT operation here, if I just add a NOT operator in an exclusive OR operator, then it becomes a XNOR. I mean to say, if I take X XOR Y, now this X XOR Y, if I take a NOT of this one, then this will give us X XNOR Y. So X XNOR Y, agar XOR ke andar hum NOT operator ko add karenge, that will give us a XNOR operator. In the same way, if I do X XOR Y, then this is equivalent to X XNOR Y whole complementation. So this whole complementation ke equal hai. And if you look at their truth values here, agar aap unki truth values ko check karenge, then you will identify that this XOR operator is having a value 1 when any one of them is 1 and the other one is true. But if both their values are same, jaise x ki bhi value 0 hai aur y ki bhi value 0 hai, when both of them are having a value 0, in this case the function is going to give us a value 0. When both of them are having a value 1, in this case the function is going to give us a value 0. But when you look at XNOR, so XNOR is basically opposite of XOR. So whenever both the values are opposite, jaise ek ki value 0 hai aur dusre ki 1 hai, ya fir ek ki 1 hai aur dusre ki 0 hai, us case mein this function will give us a value 0. Otherwise, this function will give us a value 1. That's it. Okay? I hope it is very clear. Itna sabhi ke sath clear hoga. Now, if I take these Boolean variables, right? So, if you seen in the previous example, what are x and y? X and y are Boolean variables. Why they are called as a variable? They can take different values or various values. So, if you have only one Boolean variable, right? Why? First of all, why do they call it as Boolean? Hum inko Boolean kyun bolte hain? Boolean was the name of the mathematician George Boole. So, George Boole, gave these Boolean variables. So, these Boolean variables can take two values. That is, either they can take a value true or 1, or they can take a value 0. So, they can have only two values. So, if you have only one Boolean variable here, jaise yahan par aapke paas sirf ek hi Boolean variable hai, so this Boolean variable can take only two values, which is 0 and 1. So, kitni values yahan par possible hai? There are two values that are possible. If we have two Boolean variables, now with these two Boolean variables, you can take four values. Aap four values yahan par assume kar sakte hain. So, the values are 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. So, they can take approximately four values, correct? And when you have three Boolean variables, so three Boolean variables means they can take a total of 8 values. The values are 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, 1. They can take a total of 8 values. Agar aap yahan par check karenge, yahan par in this case, when we have two variables, it took total of 2 raised to power 2 values. When we have three variables, it took a total of 2 raised to power 3 values. That means if any in any function, you have total of n Boolean values or n Boolean variables with n variables, how many such values are possible? Aise kitne unique values possible hai? That is 2 raised to power n values are possible. So here with one variable, 2 raised to power 1. With two variables, it is 2 raised to power 2. With three variables, it is 2 raised to power 3. And with the help of four variables, it will be 2 raised to power 4. With the help of five variables, it will be 2 raised to power 5 and so on. So, is tarike se inki values banegi. Okay? Now, these Boolean algebra, they are having a definite structure. So, when can we say an algebra is a Boolean algebra? Kis algebra ko hum Boolean algebra bol sakte hain? When can we say that? So, basically, a Boolean algebra follows a structure. So this is basically this is a topic in discrete mathematics which is called as structures of algebra. If any algebra is following a certain kind of axioms, then that algebra will be having a different category. Hum us algebra ko ek different category mein rakhenge. We are going to call it as we will give it as a name, right? So jaise aapke paas linear algebra hai, right? You have in the same way you have Boolean algebra. So you must have seen that even if we use intersection, union and complement, still it is called as a Boolean algebra, right? So aapke paas alag alag tarah ki Boolean algebra hai. So how can you say it is a Boolean algebra? Then any algebra, if it is having a certain kind of structure and it is following certain kind of axioms, then we call it as a Boolean algebra. Jaise, if let us suppose if we have a set A here and this is a binary operator. Binary operator means an operator that can be used on two operands. This union is again a binary operator. This not operator or complementation operator is a unary operator. And here we have two specific elements of the set, right? So there are two elements here. So this is also a Boolean algebra. Why? And it should also follow all of these rules here. So we'll discuss about them one by one. Then we can also have an algebra like this. We have a set A, we have operations which are dot operation, we have OR operation, we have the complementation operation, we have element 0 and we have element 1. So even if we have in a set A, we have the conjunction operation, we have a disjunction operation, we have a NOT operator, and now we also have a value which is false and we have a value true. So all of these algebras are examples of Boolean algebra. So what is a Boolean algebra? So Boolean algebra is a complemented distributive lattice. So what is this distributive lattice? We are going to look at it in lot of depth in discrete mathematics. जब हम discrete mathematics पढ़ेंगे तो उस समय पर हम इन सभी चीज़ों को बहुत in depth में study करने वाले हैं. So what is a Boolean algebra? A Boolean algebra or a Boolean lattice is a complemented distributive lattice which is having these six tuples. In these six tuples, you have two operators which are your binary operator. You have one operator which is your unary operator. And you have two elements of the set. आपके पास sets के दो element हैं and then they all should also follow these six axioms or can say they should also follow these six properties. कौन कौन सी property है? The first property is associativity. The second property is commutativity. Third property is absorption. Then we should have identity element. Then it should follow distributivity property. It should follow the complement property. So there should exist a complement of every element. हर एक element का complement exist करना चाहिए. So if all of these properties are followed, then we can say this algebra is a Boolean algebra. And why writing such properties is very important? Because it identifies, it tells what is the properties that the elements or the operators are following. Let me show you with the help of an example. Let me take a very easy example. मैं एक बहुत आसान example लूंगा that will show you what is the use of these operators. इन सबका benefit क्या है? देखो, if you study mathematics, जैसे आप अपनी college level पे या school level पे आपने mathematics को study किया होगा, so in your mathematics you have an addition operation, you have multiplication operation, you have division operation and you have subtraction operation. So आपके पास ये four fundamental operations है. कौन कौन से? Addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. These four operators are there. If you look at associativity property says if we have A plus B plus C, then it is equivalent to saying A plus B plus C. That means you can associate these brackets. And what are these brackets are doing? These brackets are increasing the priority. यानी कि पहले आप यहाँ पर B plus C को evaluate करो और फिर आप A को evaluate करो. And here you have to evaluate A plus B and then you have to evaluate C. So you can say this addition operation is associative, correct? In the same way, your multiplication operation is also associative. जैसे अगर आप ऐसा करेंगे A multiplied by B multiplied by C, then it is equivalent to saying A multiplied by B multiplied by C. So your multiplication operation is associative. But if you look at it here, your division operation is not associative. आपका जो division operation है वो associative नहीं है. Okay? So जैसे कि if I do A divide by B divide by C, it is not equivalent to saying A divide by B divide by C. Your division operation is not associative. Let me show you with the help of an example. Let us suppose you have three numbers, right? You have a number 2 divide by 3 divide by 4. Then it is not equivalent to saying 2 divide by 3 divide by 4. So your division operation is not associative. So it is very clear that your addition operation, your multiplication operation, they are associative. In the same way, your division operation is not associative. And you can also check the same property for subtraction operation. आप इस तरह की जो property है, उसको subtraction operation से भी check कर सकते हैं. Okay? The next operator here is your commutativity property. Now, why this commutativity property is important? So, commutativity property says, if I do A plus B, then it should be equal to B plus A. So, your addition operation is commutative. If I do A multiplied by B, then it is equivalent to B multiplied by A. So your multiplication operation is also commutative. If I do A divide by B, then it is not equal to B divide by A. A divide by B जो है, वो B divide by A के equal नहीं है. जैसे 2 divide by 5 is not equal to 5 divide by 2. So your division operation is not commutative. In the same way, your subtraction operation is also not commutative. जैसे if you do 2 minus 3, then it is not equivalent to saying 3 minus 2. So subtraction operation is also not commutative. आपका जो subtraction operation है, वो भी commutative नहीं है. Right? So you should know what are the properties these elements are following. So let us look at these properties one by one. So what are these properties? The first property here is associativity. So your AND operator as well as OR operator. Both of these two operators, which are your binary operator, or both of these binary operators are associative. Then your AND operator as well as your OR operator, both of them are commutative. Dono commutative bhi hai. Then there exists an absorption law here. So we will look at this absorption law later on, because I can show you the same with the help of a Venn diagram. I'll show you. Then there also exists an identity element. Yahan par ek identity element bhi exist karta hai. So here, what is this identity element? For OR operator, the identity element is 0. And for AND operator, the identity element is 1. ठीक है, मतलब identity element का मतलब क्या है कि if you perform the operation with the identity element, you should get exactly the same value. आप अगर identity element के साथ operation को perform करते हैं, तो आपको exactly same value ही मिलेगी. That is called as your identity element. Just like if you see multiplication, the identity element for multiplication is 1. Because if you multiply any number by 1, you will only get the same number. Right? In the same way, for subtraction, what is the identity element? For subtraction, the identity element is 0. If you subtract 0 from any number, you will always get the same number. Then you have distributivity property. So we will also look at this distributivity property with the help of a few examples. I'll show you examples is ko kaise karna hai. And I'll also show you what is a complementation property. So in your Boolean algebra right now, we are going to represent every OR operation with the help of plus sign. Yahan par hum hari OR operation ko plus sign ke sath represent karenge. And we are going to represent every AND operation with the help of a dot sign. So the first operation, the first property here is called as dominance property. And why these properties are important? Dekho, ye sabhi jo properties hai, jo sabhi naam hai, all of these names are very important, because in your exam, you get direct question based on this. You will get some operators, you will get some operations, and they will ask what kind of properties these operations or operators are following. So right now here, whenever you add 1 with any variable, agar aap kisi bhi variable ke saath aap 1 ko OR karenge, then you will always get a 1. If you AND a 0 with any variable, you will always get a 0. In the same way, for addition, or you can say for OR operation, the identity element is A. And here for AND operation, the identity element is 1. Here for idempotency, you can see idempotency means if you perform A plus A, you will get A. In the same way, if you do A dot A, you will get A. When you do complementary, that means if you do A plus A complement, you will get a 1. So this complement represents kind of an inverse element, right? So here you can see for this complementary operation, we have this A plus A complement, then that is equal to 1. For dot operation, A dot A complement is equal to 0. A plus A complement or A dot A complement jo hai, wo 0 hai. Then we have commutativity property. If you do A plus B, then it's equal to B plus A. So this A or B is equal to B or A. In the same way, A dot B is equal to B dot A, or you can say A and B is equal to B and A. So your AND operation and your OR operator both are commutative. The next property is your associativity property. So you can clearly see that your OR operation is associative, as well as your AND operation is also associative. Aapka OR operation bhi associative hai, aur AND operation bhi associative hai. Then we have distributivity property. So if we have A plus B dot C, so I can distribute this plus sign with B as well as with C. I can distribute it, so I can say it is A plus B dot A plus C. In the same way, here also I can distribute this operator. So if I do A dot B plus C, then it is equal to A plus A dot B plus A dot C. Then you have absorption property. So A dot A plus B is equal to A. So yahan par jo absorption property hai, I can also represent this absorption property with the help of a Venn diagram. Let me explain you with the help of a Venn diagram here, right? So we have A dot A plus B. This is what we have, right? Now, if you can open the bracket, so this will be A dot A plus A dot B. And if you look at this A dot A, this is equivalent to A only. So this is A plus AB. Ye kya banega aapke paas? A plus AB here. Theek hai, ye aapka banega A plus AB. Now, I can show you with the help of Venn diagram here. So if this is representing A and this is representing B, then this area which is common between them, this area is representing AB, or you can say A dot B or A and B. So the area which is common between A and B, that is called as A and B, right? So here in this case, what we are trying to do, we are trying to take this entire A. So ye aapka pura entire A hai, and we are trying to OR this entire A with this area. So you can clearly see out of all of this, we are only getting A. Hamare paas sirf A aa raha hai, so that is why it is equivalent to A only. Okay, then you have De Morgan's law. So De Morgan's law states something like this. So if you have A plus B whole complementation, it can be written as A complement dot B complement. Or if you have A dot B whole complementation, it can be written as A complement plus B complement. So these are your De Morgan's law. So this De Morgan law is going to be very, very important for you guys, because hum is De Morgan's law ko bahut zyada extensively use karne wale hain. We are going to use it very, very extensively. So please make note of these. So this PPT also I'm going to embed here in the description section of this video. So if you want to get this PPT, whatever I'm teaching right now, so you can also get the same PPT, you can download it from there. Then you have identity property. So here we have we have logical inverse. That means if you do zero complement, then zero complement is equal to one. If you do one complement is equal to zero. And then you have involution. Involution means if you do double complement of any variable, you will get the same variable. Okay. So I think all of these properties you already know. आप इसने इसके ऊपर काफी जो questions हैं आपने अपनी BTech के दौरान आपने इन सभी को काफी detail में study किया होगा. Must have studied all of these concepts in lot of detail. अब हमारे पास इन सभी ऑपरेटर्स की प्रेसिडेंस क्या है. प्रेसिडेंस मीन्स इफ इन एनी एक्सप्रेशन यू आर गेटिंग एन एंड ऑपरेटर, यू आर गेटिंग अ नॉट ऑपरेटर, यू आर गेटिंग एन ऑन ऑपरेटर, ऑल ऑफ दिस ऑपरेटर्स टुगेदर, देन विच ऑपरेशन यू हैव टू डू फर्स्ट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू शुड सॉल्व द पैरेंथेसिस, दैट इज समथिंग विच इज इन ब्रैकेट. देन यू शुड फॉलो द नॉट ऑपरेटर. उसके बाद आप फॉलो करेंगे, सॉल्व करेंगे एंड ऑपरेटर को, एंड इन द लास्ट वी आर हैविंग द ऑर ऑपरेटर. दिस इज द प्रेसिडेंस. So I'll explain you all of these precedents one by one. I'll take a lot of examples. So aapko examples se sab kuch clear ho jayega. Okay. And this is representing. Okay. Let me take an example first before I explain the De Morgan's theorem. So let me kuch take a few examples taki aapko sab kuch bahut clear rahe. I wanted that everything, whatever I'm telling you, you should be able to follow everything in a crystal clear manner. So sab kuch main bahut acche se karaunga. Just follow through my lectures. You will understand everything very clearly and clearly. So this is De Morgan's. De Morgan's means just apply De Morgan's law on this. This is what I am going to do. Okay. So here what I can see here. So if you remember what is De Morgan's law. De Morgan's law say that if we have A plus B whole complement, then it is equal to A complement dot B complement. And if you have A dot B whole complement, then it is equal to A complement plus B complement. If you remember the De Morgan's law, this is the De Morgan's law. Ye humne dekha hai abhi. We have seen this De Morgan's law. Now here in this expression, what you can see is you can assume this entire as X. You can assume this entire as Y. Then what is this equation? This equation says X dot Y whole complementation. That means I can apply De Morgan's law on this. So you can apply it in this manner. You can have A plus B complement whole complement dot C plus, so this dot will be changed to plus, this is plus, so C plus D complement whole complementation. And then here you will get A complement dot B complement complement plus, again here I applied De Morgan's law, and here also I'm going to apply De Morgan's law. So this is going to be C complement dot D complement complement, like this. So this here it will become A complement dot B plus this here it will become C complement dot D. So that means after solving this entire expression using De Morgan's law, after simplifying this expression using De Morgan's law, this is the expression that I'm getting. So ye jo expression hai ye mere paas aa rahi hai. Okay, so I think you understood what is De Morgan's law. Let me also show you the proof of De Morgan's law. So here you can clearly see I have proved the De Morgan's theorem. So De Morgan's theorem ka hai. So whenever we have A plus B whole complementation, that means we have a NOR gate. If you have A plus B whole complementation, it means we have a NOR gate. So the truth table for NOR gate is something like this. So this is the truth table for the NOR gate. So this is A, this is B and this is the truth table. So NOR gate assumes a value 1 whenever both A and B are 0, otherwise it assumes a value 0 in all the other cases. Now this A complement, A plus B whole complement, it can also be written as A complement dot B complement. So complement means I'm going to represent by a NOT operation, and this dot means I'm going to represent by an AND operation. So dot ka matlab hai hum usko AND operation se represent karenge, aur complement ka matlab hai hum usko NOT operation se represent karenge. That means it can also be represented in this manner, which is bubbled AND gate. So A, if you give a NOT here, so that is A complement. B, if you give a NOT here, that is B complement, and you are performing AND operation, so there is A complement dot B complement. And if you look at the truth table for this, this is representing A, then this is A complement. A complement means every 0 will be changed to 1, every 1 will be changed to 0. In the same way, you can also find out B complement, every 0 will be changed to 1, every 1 will be changed to 0. And then the end result here, job ka end result rahega, this as end result is going to be 100. And you can clearly see this end result and this end result, they are exactly the same. Dono ka jo result hai, wo exactly same hai. So in this manner also you can prove the de Morgan's theorem, or you can say de Morgan's law. Itna clear hai sabhi ke sath. I hope it is clear. Now let us do a few questions here. Let us solve a few questions. Let us try to reduce a few expressions using these laws. Then you will understand it more clearly. Aapko zyada acche se comfortable feel hoga, you will understand it more clearly.